So we had discussed in the previous videos HTML, Java servlet, and HTML line. So we have taken in the previous line, and we have discussed angled, open angled bracket and close. So that is called as a tag, HTML tag. So what is the title, where we need, where begins the title, where we need to end, and header also, where we had begins the header and we have to end the header. So now we are going to discuss with a complete code of that one, HTML tag, HTML. So we will see in the next slide here. As a sample, body. Let us consider that. Let us consider this following body. So a header one. So there are type of header which can be taken. H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, like that. So next span, okay, styling, style of that one, all the span will be used for the style. Span, style equal to color, RGB, red, green, blue. So whatever the values we have taken here, that color will, so in this RGB, in this line, we are going to get G or the blue color. So next line, because the remaining two R and G are zeros. So span style equal to font family, look it up bright. So at times New Roman, Veranda, or any font which are available can be taken. So span style font family, again span style font style is equal to italic, italic, New Roman, whatever that style will be taken here. And third one is the span style equal to font weight. So family will be taken, next style will be taken, weight, that equal to bold. Bold, unbold, underscore or ununderscore, whatever that can be taken. So this is an application comment here. Close the first span, okay, second, third, fourth one. So this is the what we have taken, opened, we have opened 1, 2, 3, 4, and similarly close, similar to exactly whatever we begins the content in the angled bracket tags, that same thing should be closed. Okay, so in application here, span close 1, 2, 3, 4, and close the similarly header, and close the, we have opened the body and end with body. So this is the what we say, that simple, an example, we have taken sample body contains of that one. Actually the body contains here code that determines what gets displayed in the browser's window. Finally, which is whatever we have taken, this is HTML code tags, whatever it is, all will be going to display in the browser's window. Some tags may have attributes which always provide additional information. For example, see the line, we should take it as a span here, span style color RGB, this thing. So where tag span has an attribute style which are modified so that text will be in the blue color. So the reader may have guess that when RGB stands for the amount of, we know the red, green, blue in the color, whose the values which can ranges from 0 to 255. So we know that that's what we have taken is blue is the 255. So as the example which suggests that here attribute always come in the name or value pair of the form name equal to values. They are always specified in the start tag of an HTML element. That is the major part we need to consider. So the similarly, the body contains here code to display. The body contains code to display that one. We say that an application, we have taken an application Luchida, whatever that one, the we have taken the font body which contains the string and application in the font Luchida Bright, which is bolded, italicized, so italicized, and we should be in the blue color. The last line, so that what we have taken here, an application, this should come as an all the four span tag taken with this effectively. Blue color should be, and style should be in the Luchida Bright, and style should be in italic, and it should have a bold. So the last line of this file is close HTML. We have not visible here. Close HTML tag. Obviously, it ends the entire HTML tag or entire HTML part. So now we will discuss HTML Java servlet. After that, how that the data is entering and processing HTML tag was. So here actually the reader is probably familiar with the respective web pages that allow the user to intent or the user to intend to enter the information that the system processes. For example, a search engine which provides a field in which we type in some search terms, whatever it is, when an accompanying button is clicked, the system transfers control to the search engine that displays the result of the search. So this is complete. So we are taking that this is completed by using the what is called form tag. So we are going to add the new tag is form tag, which is in a hypertext transfer, hypertext markup language. So now we are going to show that the complete code that allow us to enter some piece of text in the web pages is given below. Okay, this is the standard documentation DTD, that is the header of this HTML sentence first line. This is a doc type, so HTML is the version will be taken here, public W3C DTD HTML 4.01 transition and EN. So HTML tag, so we are going to open, start with HTML. Yes, we are ready to open. It indicates that we are ready to open. So now we are going to again open the head. So meta contents, so that equal to text bar HTML or character set. This is the, we should have taken ISO 591, the standard statement meta content. We are going to take the character set, whatever the character set will be displayed as a text is the ISO this standard that we are going to take. So now HTTP hypertext transfer protocol equivalent, so that is the HTTP equivalent equal to content type. So we are going to take the respective content type will be for the equivalent HTTP, because the applications we are going to use here HTTP protocol, so that application should be suitable to the server side. So next title page. So we are entering into the data first, opening with the title is because we are going to show that sample form. So that is the sample form will be going to show that title, sample form, title close, because title should be a short text or short notices. So sample form will be taken. So next we are going to close head, because header file is not need not be required again. So now we are going to open whatever the rest all the content which we are going to write it in the body. So that body. So now form action here, servlet package dot process input, this we could take it as a method is equal to post. So that we could take it in this form. Once again, form, that is the form page will be begins now here. Form action, that is the action page will start whenever using the form pages, because we need to enter the data and we need to processing the respective data here. Form action, servlet package process input, that is the method we have, post method we are going to see that. So which will be continued in this again next slide here, table, because the table tag. So this table tag is required after the that form page. Table tag, why? Because table tag we need to whenever the data which we should enter in terms of the rows and columns. So that is the obviously table tag is required. So we are taking table tab is open. So that we could take it as the tr tag. Okay. So that is the next after table tag, that is in the which is in the form of tr tag. So after that again we are going to take td. Okay, now td, so that align right enter data now in this particular tag, that is we can call it as a td tag, right alignment is right, enter the data, then we close and td. Okay, so type, what is that input type, text name, user id, again td close, tr tier tag close, tier tag close, td again input submit value, we say that submit value process, this is also called tr close, table close, form close, body close, html close. So here one thing we need to consider, let us general understanding of the above piece of code whatever in the previous slide and this slide we have taken, consider that the code that begins with the line we had started with the action servlet package process input method equal to post. So in this case the tag form, form tag, we are talking about the form tag, the tag form begins actually a specification of a set of element that allow the user to enter the information. The action attribute specifies that the information entered by the user is to be processed by Java class, that we have taken process input in the previous slide, a process input class which always resides in the package. So next thing here, there are two primary way in which form data which is encoded by the browser. One is get and other one is post. We have taken here post. Get means the actually the form data is to be encoded in the URL, uniform resource locator, while post method which makes the data appear within the message itself. Whenever use that post method. So that we have taken form tag, that is the action equal to forward slash servlet forward slash package dot process input, that method equal to post, that's what we have taken. So in that the next we have a in the diagrammatical representation, there we will come to know that how servlet and what is the HTML code cooperate to what is the serve the web pages. That is, so now this is the we say that the tag table. Now I am talking about table. Table tag begins the creation of table. We know that each row of the table which is described using the tr. Whenever the row we should in the table tag, tr tag will be used, and another tag td which defines in the cell in the table. Each cell in the table, that we could take it as a td, and each row if we want to increase in the table, we should take it in the tr tag. So that td input type text equal to that we have taken here, td input type text equal to name, user input equal to that td close. So thus what it does create a cell which is actually an input field where the user can enter input. That's why I have taken user input, where the user can input or enter the data. So this is the actually indicated by the angled bracket, that is the input. So we have taken, that is the input. So that input says that or two attributes. One is input tag, that input type, sorry, a name and type. So there are two attributes that input to have, that name and type, which are modified in this example. One attribute type which that which specify the type input. Here we have a text which means plain text. So we say that some other possibilities such as password also possibilities. So password which makes actually the entry which unreadable on the screen, we will be covered in the later chapter. Okay, the second attribute name after type, so that must be given a unique value. The value names the input element somewhat like identifier. Next what we say td, we will see the td input type equal to submit, so value equal to process, now close td cell. So this line, what it creates actually, which is going to create that one type button, what is the created type or button of type, types of button, submit, which whenever we click the causes of the form data to be sent to the server. So in this case the button has the particular process, that is the label called as process. Actually what will happen in the server side? Now the server side code process input is an example of servlet. Process input we have taken in the server side. So process input, that is the form, action, servlet, that package. So like that, there what will happen? So which uses the request response paradigm, we know that how that could communicate. Servlet can process the data sent using the one of the famous HTTP protocol via a form, that we told that hypertext transfer protocol. That application is the must, because servlet can process any kind of data by using a protocol, then web page will be displayed in the browser. When whatever you entered in the HTML data, all will be displayed in whatever, how many rows are created, how many columns which are created, that all will be going to see in the that table. So we create a servlet by extending the class HTTP servlet, that we have to take it as public class process input extend HTTP servlet. So that we are going to take it. So since we transmitted, we'll see in the next slide here. Okay, that actually diagrammatical representation is given. This is the diagrammatical how consideration deciding of the method which are request, what we say that request servlet and HTML, how cooperate this one. So how this going to cooperate web page? Now we say that what is that? It is nothing but architecture of for serving web pages. which is this is in diagrammatic interrupt. Assume that here an HTML page which is displayed on the client server, client browser, we say that client browser here, the page which includes among other things form that allow the user to enter some data. Here the page includes among that allow to user some data, the client make some entries in the form field and submit them by the clicking the respective button. This is user machine, this is a servlet, we have taken Java servlet. So the data in the form is then transmitted to the server and given to the Java servlet, which processes the data, generates data and generates the HTML code that is then transmitted to the client browser, which displays the page. So this is the thing here. So we are just in that previous what we had discussed by servlet, that is the post method we have taken into the transmitted from the data using post method, we need to override the method called do post. Actually this method which was two parameter, we say that we are very common, the thing is request and response. Encapsulate the data sent by the client and response to the respective client. The do post method will have the publics that is HTTP servlet request and HTTP servlet response, throws the input output exception that is called as servlet exception. Data sent by the whatever the client, the form is retrieved using the request like that user input get parameter. String input equal to request dot get a parameter or user input, what we say that. But here note that user input correspond to the name and the field, that is the data is captured and processed. The servlet creates HTML page using the response object as what we say that respond dot set content type in the HTML, that we know that printer and get writer or doc type, that is the public W3DTD or whatever we have taken on this. So in this case actually the first line state data HTML and second line begins the HTML code. The complete code of the servlet is given as in the next slide. So now this is the first the complete, the first line statement we had given in the HTML, which is described in the HTML code. The complete code for, this is the complete code for servlet is given below. Now we should take all the complete code of the servlet with the packages. So here we have started with a package, import JavaX servlet. And JavaX servlet HTTP is required, AWT event is required, Java utility is required, Java input output, and public class process input extends HTTP servlet. Okay, so here public, now we are taking that we have discussed about do post method. So do post HTTP request, we have taken request of that one, HTTP servlet response. There are two element here, we have a categorization we have taken is the request and the response, because a client is going to request and the server which will be response. So there are a lot of the communication will be done. HTTP servlet response, okay, throughs IO input output exception. So that is the servlet exception. So now input equal to request dot get parameter. So this is how we have talked about how we are taking the get parameter, that is the we say that that is the user input. So get parameter, response dot set content type, that is the text bar HTML. So whatever that set content type should be a text or HTML. Response dot get writer println, so doc type HTML, so this would be public, Again, W3C DTD document definition type or document type definition, HTML 4.01 version, similar transition that we have taken as the our response from the server get writer or print ln, we say that. So next line comes to that one, response dot get writer print ln. So HTML code, and now we are going to open it. So response dot next one is get writer header file is begins. Now response dot get writer println. So meta content data should be in the this standard format. So a text bar HTML character set should be a standard ISO 88591 that version. Hypertext transfer protocol, that is the equivalent content type should be taken in the all the body of the data. So response dot get writer println title response to input, this title should close now here, and response dot get writer println body, so header, so header should close this end. Similarly after title close, then header should close here. Response dot get writer println body. So now once he begins the body, now we have to write response dot get writer using the get writer method println. You have entered that is called as input data. So you have entered input data. Response dot get writer that close the body of HTML tag. Next we need to go for the next statement is response dot get writer println. So now we are closing complete HTML tag or HTML whatever open body of that HTML code. So here do get method we are using in the public void do get method. So this is that HTTP servlet request, okay. So HTTP servlet response which throws the input output exception, servlet exception should be do post. So that method we are going to do post request then followed by response. So we have discussed what is that one get post, similarly get or post method. So our actually one of the HTTP usage recommendation is the get method that should used only when the POM processing, that is idempotent. So idempotent, that is useful, that is the result is the same whether the POM is processed one or in case of multiple times. So actually how this definition we had already discussed about. The definition, however, should not be taken too literally. Generally speaking, if resubmitting a form doesn't change the application data stored at the server, even if changes the other entities such as log files, so it is appropriate to use to get or in other circumstance. The post method should be used to transmit in the form of data. Generally, we speaking that result from the get method, because the get method is important here compared to post, which are method are cached, but data obtained from the post are not. As a consequence, get method may execute faster than post method. So this is about a complete code of this Java servlet code, complete code of the servlet, how it is data entering or input processing and entering it into that one. So next after this is the complete set of Java servlet HTML, and we had discussed about a Java servlet code. That is the Java servlet followed by entering and processing data, how we can entering the data, how we can processing the respective data in the Java servlet. So with the help of do post, get post, get or get method, post method. So with other form tag, we have discussed the table, lines, row, or whatever it is, action that we have taken, form tag will be taken with a display different manners. So next, we are going to discuss about deploying the library system on the world wide web. So we will see that how we are going to deploying the library system on the world wide web. So this is case deploying the user requirement. So before this, we know that we now undertake the task of designing, which is and developing, say that a web version of the library system. So of course, so here we cannot do everything exactly as in the respective library. So that is the thing we need to consider here. In a particular, we do not have a machine that scan bar code on the books, but we will do as close as job as possible as the real system. So that is the thing. So now what and all required? So deploying the entire library system on the world wide web, we need to do that developing the what first thing is user requirement, interface requirement, then we need to followed by logging in and the initial menu, and we will discuss about so we would discuss about transition, state transition diagram of that one, all that add member above that, all this will be disk design and implementation. So first of all, we'll see that developing the user requirement. So as in any system, the first task is to determine the system requirement. So we will, as has been the case throughout the book here, restrict the functionality so that the system size is manageable. So first thing we are going to discuss here, first one, the user must be able to type in a uniform resource locator URL in the browser and connect to the library system. This is the very first developing user requirement as well necessary requirement also. Second one, users are classified into two categories. One is super users and one of them are ordinary users. So we'll see that what you mean by super users, what you mean by ordinary users. Super users are essentially designated library employees, and ordinary members are the general public who borrow the actual library books. So what does it and how exactly, what exactly the major difference, the major difference between the these two group of user is that super users can execute any command when logged in from a terminal in the library system, whereas ordinary members cannot access some privileged commands. So they cannot access the privilege in a particular division is which as follows. That division also has given. So that division is comes to only super users can use the following command. There are certain commands which will be privileged to the super users. So add a member, super users can add a member, add a book, super users can add a book, how many n number of books. They can add, return a book, remove a book, process, hold, save data to disk, and retrieve the data from the disk. this and all privilege will be allowed to supervisors only. They can with the help of one terminal commands. Next, ordinary members and supervisors may invoke the following command, like that both can invoke it. They can call this command. So that command is issue and renew books, place and remove hold, similarly print transaction, so and so. So this is the in one more case here, division. So every user eventually issues the exit command to terminate his or her session, where every user, both super user and ordinary users also. So now coming to the point number 3, some command here. Some command can be issued from the library only. So this is very restrictive to that. Only some command. I mentioned here some command. These include all of the command that only super user has access to and command to issue the book. Whenever they issue the book, they can have that one. Actually, a super user cannot issue the fourth point coming to that. A super user cannot issue any command from the outside of the library system. They can log in, but the only command choice will be to the exit the system. So this is the thing here. So they can log in, and but the thing is, the only command choice will be to the respective exit only. So fifth one point coming to this. So super users have a special user IDs. They will have their own special user IDs and corresponding password also. For regular members, their library member ID will be their user ID. In case of ordinary or regular member, their user ID and their phone number will be is the always be the password. So their phone number will be as considered as the respective password. So this is what developing the what is the user requirement we had. Depending upon the restrict to the functionality, so that system size is manageable, what they can do, what are the requirement, user must be able to URL of that, okay, user two categories, always super user and ordinary users, and command issues, who can enter the some commands on the library persons, and super user, we know that they are cannot issue any command from outside the library. Even the super users, they have the issue the any issue in the command inside the library only. Super users which have, they have their own special IDs and the respective password. So the next video we will continue that interface requirement of this deploying the library system on the World Wide Web, and followed by logging in, and what is the initial menu, what it does for the initial menu, and what and all the state transition diagram, we'll see in the next videos.